Well, this might have been the site of Bristol's rural post office open on March 1st, 1911 in this area. Or maybe not. We are standing on a tongue of proglacial outwash looking west, down Highway 13, the Red Coat Trail. Cadillac's Cadillac, Saskatchewan. It's July 24th, 2012. Listen, brown-eyed Susan's in the ditch. Some curled dock. Religious curled dock. And there is a bridge that the CPR laid on the line that they ran through here in 1914 between Assiniboia and Shawnaman. Is crossing Highway 13, the Shaughnavan Sub. The line and many other miles of CPR trackage in southern Saskatchewan have been owned by the Great Western Railway since 1999, which since 2004 has been locally owned. That was the former Saskatchewan Wheat Pool A elevator built in 1958, renovated in 1977, and looking westward into Cadillac, 18 kilometers west from Pontex. You can see the old school and the church spire. Our Lady of Confidence. Well, you could camp in Cadillac, get some gas and a cup of coffee. According to the sign, on the eastern edge of town, some nice ball diamonds, well maintained. They take your baseball seriously here. And the arena, skating rink, curling rink. Oh, more ball diamonds. That'll be the curling rink there, I think. And on Main Street, an old Mercury, a veteran of many a mile. Hot-bellied stove outside what looks to be an old bank building. And a hotel, the Cadillac, a 1947 rebuild of an original structure which burned in 1946. Looking west down what might be Railway Avenue. At mile 82.7 from Assiniboia, CPR built a standard Western Line Station A2, right around here somewhere, in 1914. It closed in 1969, 2 years after passenger service was suspended. It was sold off in 1973, and we'll see it farther up Main Street. Looking north up Main. This is the east side of Main this morning. Probably an old implement dealership. Farming settlers began arriving in this area from around 1907, bolstered by a large influx of French speakers in 1910. There goes the patrol. The CPR laid out the town site in 1913 after they ran their raid by here, and the community began to coalesce. Post office moved in on January the 1st, 1914. Old Presbyterian Church, that cross, or maybe Anglican. Now the museum. All sorts of interesting junk. And central to so many Saskatchewan communities is the cenotaph. This one doesn't have a list of names. There's the school, built in 1916. Not sure when it closed, but it's now the summer residence of the artist Robert Austin Scott from Edmonton and Melfort. There's the community hall. And on the right is the station that I mentioned before. Standard Western Lines A2. Our Lady of Confidence. Must date from the 20s, it looks. There's a better look at the station. The standard number 14A station from Crichton is in town somewhere as well, to the north of the highway. Cadillac street names all follow an automotive theme. And we are in Saskatchewan Rough Rider country. Oh, a fancy birdhouse. Cadillac was incorporated as a village on July the 2nd, 1914, and remains so. And this will be the main business street here. Busy in the public garden she is. Trim those bushes. There's the back of the hotel. And the post office, which opened on July 2nd, 1914. Not there, but open in town somewhere. And there's a concrete brick building. Maybe those concrete bricks are from Pang, farther east down the line. Well, there he is. Float to open his dealership. One of the last businesses in town. Some veteran buildings. And some veteran trucks. South of town on Highway 4 is the cemetery. And the last elevator in town, the Saskatchewan Wheat Pool, has had a presence here since its inception in 1924. I don't know what other companies would have been set up here. Maybe McCabe, Pioneer, United Grain Growers. On rolling hills of undifferentiated glacial moraine, Cadillac, Saskatchewan.